Hello, I'm Dr. Vineet Mannan. I am a laparoscopic and general surgeon. My area of expertise is laparoscopic hernia, laparoscopic cholecystectomy, and laser surgeries for piles, fissure, and fistula. Inguinal hernia is commonly seen in the groin region. It can occur on both sides or on one side, depending on the patient's condition. The main reason why hernia occurs is due to the weakness of the abdominal wall. So there are various openings in the abdominal wall which allow structures from inside the abdomen to come out and vice versa. So in such openings, or the wall that is around these openings become weak, there is enlargement of the opening, therefore causing the structures which should not normally come out from these openings to come out along with the regular structures. So in the inguinal hernia, there is something called as the inguinal canal present in the male, wherein this intestine or fat inside the abdomen may push through along with the regular structures that come through it and may come out into the open. This is called as inguinal hernia. They are of two types. One is an inguinal hernia indirect type and a direct type. Now, indirect type is when it comes through the canal, inguinal canal, and direct type it when it tries to push through the wall and just come out into the open. The main reason why inguinal hernia is seen is due to increase in the abdominal pressure. The abdominal pressure may increase due to various reasons like continuous cough, wherein the person keeps coughing, so it involves the chest and the abdomen. Patient has got constipation, wherein the patient has to strain excessively and continuously multiple times while passing stools. And in conditions like benign prostatic hyperplasia or strictures in the urethra, where the person has to strain while passing urine. These conditions essentially increase the abdominal pressure to a point wherein the abdominal wall tends to weaken over a period of time, and the openings in the abdominal wall are not supported by the surrounding structure and then cause the hernia. These are called hernial orifices through which the contents come out. These contents can be reduced back by pressing onto them slowly and pushing it back, or in the initial stages when the person lies down, it may go back on its own. The symptoms of an inguinal hernia are a swelling, which may be painless. Initially, the patient will give a history that it was small during the initial days and has been slowly growing in size and has been shifting more towards the midline than it was before. So very rarely this swelling may have associated pain. The main reason for the pain is because the contents or the intestine or the fat that has come out through the opening may be getting less blood supply than they should, because of the stricture effect of the opening through which they have come out. So this is an emergency condition and needs to be tended to immediately. If the person has a swelling associated with pain in the swelling, then he or she must go immediately to the doctor or surgeon and show it.